Welcome back, everyone. Great to have you here today. As always, we are getting started with our Friday review this week. Love being able to tap into all of the different things we've been going over for the past week. I've got some brand new debuts for you today. Can't wait to bring you that. But before we do, before we bring you the research, the product reviews, and I've got a few here today, I actually want to share with you just, I'm always amazed. I'm definitely one of those people that, I like to look at the, we'll say smoothie here, if you're watching this online, the smoothie half full. But, you know, I look at life as at least opportunity. You know, it's not always great. It's not always rainbows and sunshine and unicorns like my, you know, youngest daughter loves to believe in. It's not like that all the time, and I get it. But I do love opportunity and love the opportunity that, hey, maybe every week's not going to be the greatest. There's no doubt about that. I had one of those weeks last week. I definitely had one of those weeks. Happy to be recovering from that now. But the truth is this, it's like I was really looking forward to this summer. I can't believe that we're already getting into mid-August, which is wild. And again, like I'm not reminiscing already that the summer is gone. But what I look at is like, you know, these are some really strange times we're living in. Like no matter what your beliefs, no matter what your stance, any of those things, these are some interesting times we're living in. And again, I don't know about you, but I'm just trying to enjoy more of the moments. You know, that's really how I see things right now. So I'm trying to enjoy more of, at least right now, being able to go to the beach with my daughters, be able to take them on a hike, you know, do my podcast that I love to do, all these different things. But one thing that I've been doing definitely a lot more of, and I would love to hear if you've been ramping it up a little bit too, is just now that at least, you know, here in the US and in the, let's say, Western Europe and Canada and the US and all around. I know our friends in Australia, it's opposite seasons, but I've been doing a lot more exercise. I've been getting out a lot more. I'm talking about 5 days a week and on the weekends, just really being active, 13,000, 15,000 steps and just having fun with friends and family. But for me, it's been an opportunity not to overtrain, not to overexercise, but really get out there. I mean, even when I'm up in Maine, I get into the ocean and it's so cold. It's so freezing cold, but I was in it the other day and I was actually swimming. I was doing some longer distance swimming, which felt great. Now I was a little numb when I got out, but it was great to be out there. Great to be doing that. So been just trying to enjoy the summer as much as I can, enjoy exercise along with it. Love to hear what you've been doing this summer as well, or winter for our friends in Australia. So definitely let me know below if you're watching this on YouTube. And again, it's just my name, Stephen Cabral on YouTube with a PH, and the same for Instagram too. So let me know. I'd love to hear from you. Now, in terms of what we have going on over at, I'd be remiss if I didn't show you this. My team just sent me this in the mail, which is pretty cool. They did it as just kind of like, I don't know, just saying, hey, we put in a lot of hard work. This is the Integrative Health Practitioner IHP2. So level two, when you pass level two, you get this beautiful university quality blue jacket. And inside, you get this beautiful IHP level 2 certificate. So, I mean, they did such a phenomenal job. I mean, this is just something amazing that you can frame or keep it inside of this nice jacket as well. But our level 2s, you know, they've accomplished so much by achieving that and really set themselves apart from all other health coaches with really the ability to be able to read at-home functional medicine labs and help people that much more in their journey. So just love seeing this. I think it's pretty impressive. So I just wanted to show it to you. It's on my desk and they made it out in my name, which is kind of funny. So thank you to my team, my HP team. You're all amazing. And that goes to Angela and Jessica and Katie and Caitlin and so many other people behind the scenes as well. So once again, thank you. I appreciate you. Daniel as well on social, Michelle. All right. So next up, I always let you know that whatever we have going on EquiLife, I want to be able to share with you. And if I can ever get it to you for free, that's always my goal. So this week over at EquiLife, this was a pop-up, literally a pop-up with my team. We've got a lot of people on our team, a lot of moms, a lot of dads, probably more moms than dads on the EquiLife team. And we're always thinking of fun gifts. And this was something that we all thought was a great idea. So what this is a lunch cooler bag and it's insulated. So you can see inside, nice big top pocket. You could put, I'm always thinking about, you know, my girls here. So I'm like, all right, so we could put an apple in there. We could put a couple snacks. We could put their little lunch box in there with an ice pack and that's going to stay really cold. We can just zip that right up. But the other interesting thing, again, if you're not watching this on video, that's okay. It's always at stephencabral.com/2016 as well. That's today's show notes page with all the links that I'll be talking about here today. But it also, so the reason why I love this is because there's obviously, there's a lot of cooler bags, right? This one though has a whole bottom to it. Look how big the bottom is to this lunch cooler bag. So basically if you're listening, it's basically like, I don't know, a big, triangular based shape, not quite triangular. It has a top to it. So let's say more square with a top pocket and a bottom pocket. And you can actually separate out a lunch and a dinner if you're taking this to work, or certainly a thermos for kids or a smoothie bottle for kids. It can have its own ice pack in the bottom. And then on the outside of the bag, there's an extra pocket. And the pocket could be for your vitamins or, you know, my girls get one of these each day, which is an organic Whole Foods bar. And this one's the chocolate brownie indulgence. These are all organic bars, and you can put that right in the pocket on the outside so that it's not part of the ice pack. So, I mean, it's just a great versatile bag. It's $20. You get it completely free though with all qualifying purchases over at equi.life. That's EQUI.LIFE. All right. That's what's going on over at EquiLife. Oh, I pulled up my daily nutritional support for you just to show you one last thing. How big these pockets are. Well, I'll show you the bottom one. It fits perfectly within the bottom one. It can close up for your detox. You can put it in the top. You get the gist. All right, so that is that for what's going on over at EquiLife. I wanted to make sure that you knew about episode 2012, 5 life skills everyone should master. That was a pretty popular one this week. That was on Monday. 2013 was how not to overfast and shut down your hormones. That's a big one. That deals with the thyroid, but it also deals with progesterone and affecting a lot of women too with weight gain, inflammation, etc. Now, it affects men too, so don't think that thyroid's not affected for men, because 1 out of 10 men have thyroid issues. 1 out of between 5 and 8 women have low thyroid. Okay, so 2014 was 7 warning signs you're wearing out your adrenals. I wish I knew this 25 years ago, but that's why I teach it today, right? Because if I knew it, I would have gotten healthier a whole lot faster. But of course, I wouldn't be where I am today, and so I'm grateful for that. And then episode 2015, just yesterday, we talked about how to beat fatigue with the number one reason you need to be exercising. A lot of people say, I'm going to exercise to lose weight. That is the worst reason to exercise. And I go through that on the podcast. There are so many better reasons to exercise. And remember, even if you don't need to lose weight, you need to be exercising. And I go through that on the show. That was yesterday. Again, you can find all these podcasts at stephencabral.com/podcasts. All right. 2 product reviews for you today. The first one is, so I have my Apple Watch on. People always ask me, because I take photos and I post on Instagram, you know, are you going to keep wearing the Apple Watch? Because I did a review for it a few weeks back. If you didn't see my head-to-head Apple Watch versus Oura Ring review, please do go back and check that out. That was, let's see if I can find it here. It was a Thursday show. I know that for sure. And it was after my interview with Clint on earthing. It was after different types of CBD. Oh, there it is. It was episode 1987. So we'll link that up today. If my team can link up 1987, Apple Watch versus Oura Ring, you can check it out. I'm still wearing both, but you'll see the breakdown and what I would recommend if you can only get one. But one thing I didn't mention, and this is pretty wild that I didn't mention this, the Apple Watch has a great biofeedback based feature. It's so simple. You can set it for a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes. I think you can set it for pretty much whatever you want. And all it does, and again, I would show you, but if I showed you and turned it away, the nice thing about the Apple Watch is there is a privacy to it. So if I face it away from me, the watch face basically goes black or just kind of shows the watch face. But what it does is there's a circle that expands as you inhale, and then as you exhale, the circle shrinks. And then you inhale, and again, you're inhaling based on the circle expanding, and then it shrinks. This is a normal biofeedback. Typically, you see the circle coming together as you exhale and then expanding as you inhale. That's typical of most biofeedback devices, or you see a wave pattern, and that Leaf Therapeutics device does that. So those are common, but why am I mentioning it then? Well, there's a lot of features is what I'm saying. About the Apple Watch. And that's one more added feature that you can do biofeedback whenever you want right on your watch. And I always talk about my watch face, but my watch face shows my heart rate when I want it, biofeedback when I want it, and exercise when I want it. And then it shows activity throughout the day because I use my Apple Watch, as I spoke about in 1987, as a true motivator. Like it is literally on my wrist, motivating me the whole day. How's it motivating me? Well, it's basically saying, listen, I said it for myself. You need to get 400 to 500 extra calories in activity. You need to get at least 20 minutes of exercise, and you need to get at least 12 standing hours per day. That means standing for at least 1 minute, 12 hours a day. And I love it for that fact. It doesn't have to do anything else. Again, it's on Bluetooth, it's on airplane mode, but it does track all of my progress. And so I really do like that. And again, it comes with a free breathwork based app right on the iPhone. I mean, right on the Apple Watch. So again, I don't own any stock in Apple. They don't pay me for saying this, but it is a pretty nice device. I'm telling you that. So, all right. That is that second product review of the week. A lot of people have been asking this. They've said, do you use a continuous glucose monitor? And the answer was, yes, I used to, and I used it for a couple weeks. Okay. People have heard me talk about the Dexcom I used before. I like it. Why didn't I continue to talk about it? Because you needed a doctor's sign off in order to be able to get it. And people were asking their doctors for it. The doctors were saying no. When, by the way, isn't it better to work on not getting type 2 diabetes in the first place rather than getting type 2 diabetes and then being able to sign off on it? Conventional medicine makes no sense to me. I mean, it's literally sick care. We'll help you when you get so bad you have a disease, but we won't help you before that. And again, like it just blows my mind. So again, I'm not saying that you shouldn't have a doctor. You should. And remember, your doctor is not at fault. A medical doctor has to play within the system of insurance. It is an insurance and pharmaceutical industry, not your doctor's industry. Your doctor has to play by the rules of the practice they're in or the hospital, insurance, and pharmaceuticals. You want your medical doctor, and they're fantastic and they're brilliant, don't get me wrong, but that's why you also need to have an integrative health practitioner or naturopathic doctor. Just there's no question about it. So now I've been sorting through about a half a dozen continuous glucose monitor companies. I narrowed it down to three that were the three best, and I chose one. And I chose this company for a very specific reason. And before I get into that, I just want to share with you this. I haven't used it yet. I'm going to be using it over the next 6 weeks, and then I'm going to do a full review. But a continuous glucose monitor is basically a patch you can put on your belly. Most people put it on the back of their arm where their tricep is. And it does exactly what it says it's going to do. It is a continuous glucose monitor. It monitors your glucose basically every minute of the day. And so it will show you which foods are spiking your blood sugar. And it will also show you if you start to drop into hypoglycemia. And that's obviously not a good thing either, because then you're getting an artificial, or I should say an endogenous spike of blood sugar from breaking down your own liver glycogen or muscle-based tissue. So the company I chose to go with, and again, wait just about 6 weeks. I'll be with a full review and everything because I want to make sure that this is a product that I'm going to recommend. It's called Nutrisense. Again, there was three great companies out of the six that I looked at. And get ready to know you better. And that's what it's doing. It's basically looking at your blood sugar through the day. And this is it. Very simply packed. They've got two of the CGMs in here, continuous glucose monitors. And one of the reasons why I really like the company too is you put this water resistant patch over it. Cause I swim in the, I'm swimming the ocean. I'm going to be swimming in the pool this fall, for more sprint triathlon training. And this can go right over it, which is great. So I don't catch it on anything because you don't want to catch the monitor on anything. And then you get this simple card to get set up. So basically what you do is you log into the app, and the password is your 10 digit phone number. You apply your sensor right to the back of your arm, if that's where you choose to do it. And then you activate your sensor. That's basically it. Wait 30 minutes before your first scan. During the first 12 to 24 hours, your sensor may show a lot of variability. I'm used to that. Most biometric devices take a week. This won't, but a week to get your biometrics proper, like your HRV, is usually all over the map. With the Apple Watch the first week, I had like 150. Then one day I had like 75, and then it was up to like 110, and then 55. So it's getting to kind of know you, and then it does a better job. And then just make sure you scan every 8 hours to pull up that data. So the sensor can be worn underwater up to 30 minutes at a depth of 3 feet or less. So that's good for me doing pool lap swimming. And dispose of the sensor after 14 to 15 days and just replace it with another. So that's it. So I have 6 weeks worth of sensors, I believe. Let's see here. I believe I have 6 weeks. Well, I think I have 30 days in this. I'll have to order more. But essentially every month they send you another CGM packet. So I'm going to give you all the updates on that. That's the company I'm going with. Stay tuned. I'll be definitely posting it on my Instagram stories as well. So continue to check in. I'm going to start this in about 2 weeks or so from now. All right. So that is that. That's the product reviews for this week. I'll bring some book reviews soon, but I wanted to bring that to you. A lot of people have been asking. Two research studies I want to bring you. The first is scientists reverse age-related memory loss in mice. I've been trying to talk more about the brain, more about Alzheimer's, more about dementia, because I know how many people it's affecting. Well, good news is this. The brain we've known for a long time is plastic, which means it's malleable, which means that we should be able to bring parts of it back to life, even if damaged. And that is now what they're showing in mice, which is, again, the first parts to scientific study. Typically are happening in either a petri dish or they're happening with rats and mice. And so scientists at Cambridge and Leeds have successfully reversed age-related memory loss in mice and say the discovery could lead to the developments of treatments to prevent memory loss in people as they age. The study was published in Molecular Psychiatry. And it works on the scaffolding around the nerves, which lead to loss of memory with aging, but that it's possible to reverse these using genetic treatments. So recent evidence has emerged of the role of what's called perineuronal nets, PNNs for short. So if you start to see PNNs in the news, you know that's perineuronal nets, which basically talks about neuroplasticity, and that's the ability for the brain to learn and make new connections. And so essentially what they showed was using, I believe it's chondroitin. Let me see if this is it. I know for sure that it's a form of chondroitin sulfate. Yes, 6-sulfate chondroitin sulfates were able to help with the PNNs and found that this completely restored memory in older mice. And these were done on 20-month-old mice, which is considered really old for mice. And so they said, this is a direct quote, "We saw remarkable results when we treated the aging mice with this treatment. The memory and ability to learn were restored to levels they would not have seen since the mice were much younger." I mean, this is pretty remarkable. So that's why, again, I'm not against conventional medicine. What I'm against is treating chronic-based disease with pharmaceuticals when we know that everything has an underlying root cause. And yes, I would love for people never to get Alzheimer's and dementia in the first place because they were following the de-stress protocol of diet and exercise and stress reduction. Again, not making any medical claims, right? We're not providing any treatment protocols, but a healthy body doesn't get sick. I mean, that's basically the way that it is. We didn't have the level of Alzheimer's even 100 years ago, and certainly not 200 years ago. Was there some? Sure, some, but nowhere near this level. And then there'll be a lot of people to say, well, people didn't live until their later 70s and 80s. They did. Remember, you have to understand, is like people were always able to live this long. The reason why life expectancy wasn't as long, yes, there was disease that wiped out a lot of people. Yes, there's no doubt about it, but it's because child mortality rates were so high during childbirth. And so that's one of the biggest reasons, the biggest reason why life expectancy was always lower. All right. So I'm going to link that up. You want to learn more about this? I would, again, if someone in your family is suffering from this, maybe they're, and they're declining rapidly, again, work on natural health, but you might be able to get your hands on some of these experimental-based treatments. They're considered experimental because they haven't been done with human studies yet. All right, second research study, and let me just read it to you first. Higher levels of omega-3 acids in the blood increases life expectancy by almost 5 years. A 1% increase in the substance in the blood is associated with a change in mortality risk similar to that of quitting smoking. This was done on about 2,240 people for 11 years over the age of 65. I'm telling you right now, you have to be getting omega-3s in your diet. There are so many people out there who try to scare you, and I won't name the person's name, with research from one individual on polyunsaturated fats that, of course, have been oxidized. We are not talking about oxidized omega-3s. We're talking about wild fish or natural omega-3s from also from plant-based foods and getting your omega-3 levels to a 3-to-1 from omega-6s to omega-3s. It doesn't have to be a 1-to-1. A 3-to-1 is phenomenal. And a 9% saturation rate helps decrease cardiovascular death by over 90% according to a very large published study. And now this is saying that if you increase your omega-3s in your blood, you add 5 more years to your life almost without doing anything, because in this study over 11 years, these people weren't necessarily doing anything special. This is tracking people in their everyday life. Those who had higher levels of omega-3s had 5 more years of life expectancy. So you're, whether you're smoking or not smoking, whether you're exercising or not exercising, eat wild fish 4 to 5 times a week or supplement with omega-3s that are triglyceride bound, that are cold processed, that are checked for heavy metals, that are healthy omega-3s, right? Because there are unhealthy ones that you buy at Costco or CVS or all these places for very cheap money that are oxidized, that are terrible for you. But if you get natural ones, how your body would typically absorb them, then you get all the benefits. And again, we back all of this by clinical studies ourselves. So we have conventional medicine saying the same thing as natural health. The one that I use every day, omega-3 support, plain and simple, the best one out there. It's a 2-to-1 ratio of EPA to DHA. You can find at Equi.life. Very, very easy to use. Again, use your favorite one. Just make sure it's a functional medicine brand. It doesn't have to be EquiLife, but use a functional medicine brand so that you know that it's being tested for heavy metals and that it's cold process and that it's triglyceride bound and it's coming from sustainable wild fish, all of those different things. All right. So anyway, the reason why I'm very passionate and amped up about this is that this is easy to do, that anybody can do. And it's like $1 a day could add 5 years to your life. I mean, and there are so many people like, oh, you can't eat, you know, polyunsaturated fats. No, you can. You don't want to eat oxidized polyunsaturated fats, right? It's the oxidation that's the issue. So I'm going to keep it at that. I'm going to link up the research for you today at StephenCabral.com/2016. And that is it for today. Fired up into this weekend. I hope you have an amazing weekend. Come on back tomorrow. We'll be going through our community's questions on the Cabral House Calls. Take care, everyone.